Good morning, students. Today I am going to continue chapter number 3, Money and Credit from Economics. And today's topics are, number 1 is loan activities of bank, number 2 is two different credit situations, and number 3 is terms of credit. But students, first of all, we will take overview of the chapter and we will discuss about the previous topics which I had already explained to you. So students, as you know very well that money is a very important and essential part of life. And whatever we want to buy, we can buy with the help of money. And money is playing very important role for the transaction of any good and services. And if we have money, then we can easily exchange it for any commodity or service that we might want. But students, one question will arise here, that how money is came to existence and what people do earlier when there is no any existence of money. So students, earlier when there were no any kind of money in existence, then people used barter system. Again, one question will arise here, that what is barter system? So students, barter system is a system that was used in ancient times to exchange goods. Or in another words, we can say that this system was used to exchange one commodity for another before the monetary system or money system came into existence. Okay? For example, if a person having rice and wants tea, then he can exchange rice with the person who has tea and needs rice. So that kind of transaction of goods and services from one to another is known as barter system. And it means commodity is exchange for commodity. But students, there are many problems which were related to the barter system, and that was coincidence of wants or double coincidence of wants. Again, one question will arise here, that what is double coincidence of wants? So students, double coincidence of wants implies that needs of two individuals should complement each other for the exchange to take place. For example, in the above case, the second person must need rice in exchange of tea. But students, again, one problem was related to the double coincidence of wants, and that was lack of common unit of value. So students, under barter system, there was no common unit for measuring the value of one good in terms of the other good for the purpose of exchange. Okay? For example, a horse cannot be measured in terms of rice in the case of exchange between rice and horse. Okay? So students, now you can understand that there is no any common measurement related to the cost of tea with rice or cost of horse or any animal in the compare of rice. So that time it was very difficult to exchange commodities from another commodities, and it was also very difficult to store commodities for a long time for exchange purposes. So students, anyhow, money came to existence to measure the unit of value and to solve out the problem of barter system and double coincidence of wants. Okay? But students, in our pre-Indian history, after the existence of money, kings and earlier people made coins with the help of precious metals like gold, silver, copper, etc. And that was too costly. And that money, form of money, whatever made by the precious metals, also cannot measure the all things whatever people wants to buy, because of there was major gap among the people, like very rich and poor, and that was very common in that time. Most of the kings and rich people were using the precious metals and coins, whatever made by precious metals. So students, and also due to the continuous use of that precious metals to make coins, that was started to decrease in quantity. That's why scientists and people discover the another form of coin which were made by the common metal and which can use and accepted by everyone. Okay? After that, finally, that coin was used from that time to now till time, till people used that form of money as a medium of exchange. And finally, nowadays, in modern days, we are using paper notes and coins. And that paper notes is known as currency and accepted by all people who are living in India. And students, this medium of exchange, for example, coin and paper money, as a medium of exchange accepted by all, because that coin and paper money or currency is authorized by the government of India. And in India, the Reserve Bank of India issues currency notes on behalf of the central government. And every institution of India and every people is allowed to use that form of money as a medium of exchange. And no one can refuse as a mode of payment to settling the transaction. All right? And this is widely accepted as a medium of exchange in India. Okay? After that, your next topic was deposits with banks. So students, as you know very well that in the month of every year, finally, end of the month receives salary, and people who are doing any economic activity on the per day wages, they can also able to save some money. So students, workers or anyone who receives their salary at the end of each month or every day have extra cash at the beginning of the month. So students, for the saving purpose, for further use or for future use, sometime people deposit that money in the bank because no one wants to keep that extra saving or money at their home or houses. For saving purpose, that extra cash kept by the people in the banks by opening a bank account in their name in the bank. And banks also accept that deposits, whatever deposit by the different people in the bank, and also bank pay an amount as an interest on the deposits. Okay? So students, in this way people can save and keep their money in the banks and are able to earn some money in the form of interest whenever they want to withdraw. And students, people also have a provision and also have a good chance to withdraw their money any day from the bank accounts. And that money, whatever withdraw by the people any day or any time, that is called or known as demand deposits. Okay? All right? Okay? And students, this is a very important facility which provided by bank to the people. Okay? In this way, they can deposit their money and they can also settling the transaction with the help of check. So students, again one question will arise here, that what is a check? So students, check is a facility against demand deposit, makes it possible to directly settle payments without the use of cash. And as I told you above that, demand deposits are accepted widely as a means of payment along with currency. Okay? But students, this payment you can settle down with the help of check also. And check is also issued and authorized by the Reserve Bank of India to settle down the payment without the use of money. Okay? So students, for payment through check, the payer who has an account with the bank makes out a check for a specific amount. And a check is a paper instructing the bank to pay a specific amount from the person's account to the another person in whose name the check has been issued. All right, students. So in India, and I think in all over the world, this is a very easy, very popular mode of payment. All right. And check and demand deposits, all these are closely linked to the working of the modern banking system. And students, after that, your next topic is loan activities. So students, you know very well that if people can deposit their money in the bank as a form of saving, and anyone can withdraw as a demand deposit from the bank, so our banks also given us a facility to take our money from the bank in the form of loan. Okay? And students, you know very well that nowadays, to increase business, to start new and economic activities, sometimes people are unable to arrange money from their relative or anyone. That why governments provide a facility to take loan from the bank. And deposits money and giving loan, this is a very important and interesting mechanism of the bank. As I told you above that, banks deposits people's money, and students, here banks playing a role of mediator between those who has surplus amount. It means those who has deposited his money in the bank, and those who need money. It means those people who wants to take loan from the bank. Okay? And bank accepts deposits from the bank account holders who have excess amount. Okay? And students, bank stores only a small portion of this amount as a provisions for user who wish to withdraw money. And in India, banks keeps only 15% of the total amount whatever deposited by people in one day. Okay? And the major portion of the money is offered as a loan to those who need money. Okay? And students, again one question will arise here, that what is loan? So students, loan is an amount given by bank in which bank provide money to the needy with an assurance to pay the amount with the extra amount charged as interest. Okay? And students, a person who deposits the amount in the bank account called as depositor, and a person who borrows money from the bank is called a borrower. All right? And student, very important point which you have to note, that the rate of interest on loan is higher than the rate of interest bank offer on the deposits. Okay? And whatever money deposited by the people in the bank given extra money in the form of interest on the particular amount of money. Okay? And whatever loan given by bank to any needy person to do any economic activity, to start new business, or for any purpose, for making home or house, etc., then banks gives loan to them on the basis of interest rate. It means whenever any borrower wants to return the loan of bank, then he has to give also some extra amount as a form of interest to the bank. Okay? And the difference between the amounts earned from the borrowers to the amount given to depositors is the main source of income for any bank. Okay? In simple way, you can understand like this. Whatever interest given by bank to the depositor and whatever interest taken by the bank on the loan, whatever given by bank to the people, the difference between the two interest is a income of any bank. Okay? After that, your next topic is two different credit situation. But students, first of all, we have to understand here what is credit and what is the definition of credit. So students, credit is a kind of agreement in which lender supplies the borrower with the money, goods or services in return for the promise of future payments. And student, this term of credit we can understand with the help of two examples. First example is related to the Salim, who was the shoe manufacturer. And he receives an order or 3,000 pair of shoes to be delivered in a month. And to complete the order, he needs some money or resources like workers, raw materials, and he has no money to make that pair of shoes. That's why he asks for some money to buy raw material from the supplier and promise to pay him later. And supplier of raw material giving them raw material or money only on the basis of credit, that if anyhow Salim will not able to return his money, then he can take all the shoes and can fulfill his money. So students, he asked raw material supplier to supply raw material now and promises to pay him later. He then obtained loans in cash as an advance payment from the person who gave the order. So this way he have solved his present wants of capital needs, and the finally at the end of the month he is able to complete the order and earn money. It means whatever shoes made by the Salims, that was totally sell buy them in the market with a good price and also good earning. Finally, he is able to return money to that person from which he has taken the loan. Okay, so shoes was as a kind of credit. Okay, after that, in the next example of Sapna, Sapna was a farmer and she took loan from a money lender to complete his requirement related to the cultivation of crops, and due to bad weather condition her crop fails and she was unable to repay loan to the money lender, and after over year the loan grows to a large amount and Swapna trapped in a debt. Or we can say the situation of Sapna is called debt trap, and the farmer is now caught in the debt trap, and to pay off the debt, farmer has to sell off his part of land. So students, in this case the credit creates negative impact on the business. And students, you know very well that in villages mostly people takes loan, whether they are rich farmer or poor farmer, to complete the needs and requirement of the cultivation. And farmers who are aware from the policies of the bank, they are taking loan from the bank. But Swapna types of farmer who is very poor and also unaware about any policy of the government, then they takes loan from the money lender. Okay, and due to the bad condition, weather condition, or anyhow, like Swapna, if crop fail, then credit pushes the person into a debt trap. And in another condition, sometime we can say in the case of Salim, in one situation credit helps to increase earnings and therefore the person is better off than before. And in the case of Swapna, credit pushes the Swapna into a debt trap, and to repay her loan she has to sell a portion of her land. So students, now you can clearly understand that her condition is worse off than before. So students, I want to clear here that what is debt trap. So students, this we can understand with the help of case of Swapna. So students, in Swapna's case, the failure of the crop and loan repayment was impossible. That's why she had to sell her part of agricultural land to repay the loan. And credit, instead of helping Swapna and improve her earning, left her worse off or in very bad condition. So students, the above example of Swapna, we can understand that is debt trap. And credit in this case pushes the borrower into a situation from which recovery is very painful. Okay?